right, what's up everybody, Sky here. Excuse me, but welcome back to the shit I bought this month. Yeah, I'm sorry I haven't really been able to upload anything on my YouTube channel. I'm kind of in the process of finding a new job right now because I quit the place that I worked at because they were fucking assholes. But I already got a new job, so I'm kind of figuring that stuff out right now, and I'm gonna start there next Tuesday. And it's actually a job where I work in town, so I'll be home every day. So I'm gonna be able to upload a lot more shit, and I'm gonna be able to do a lot more retro stuff because I can't really, I mean, I can bring like the PS4 and like PSTV with me, but I wasn't gonna bring no fucking PS2 because it's so old. It just takes one little good bump and it's done for. So wouldn't do anything like that, but yeah, it's just a little update. I'm gonna start uploading some more shit this weekend, try to get some gameplays, but I've just been busy, and it's just, I gotta make money, man. So because I buy stupid shit like this fucking thing that I'm about to show you right now, but I haven't got quite that much stuff this time because I pretty much got everything I want. The only other games that I want now are, I pretty much just want to collect the rarer shit on PS2. There's like 3 PS2 games I'm trying to get right now. There's Haunting Ground, there's Rule of Rose, and Kuon. And all of those games are fucking like almost $200. I could have gotten Haunting Ground for $100 the other day. I'm not sure. I may go and get it if they still have it, but it has to be complete because I'm tired of buying this rare shit and it's not complete, and I have to go sourcing, trying to find other ways to get a case for it. I fucking hate that shit. I want it to already have the case, preferably the manual, but it all depends. But I went to the Salvation Army in town and I found these fucking Genesis games, dude. And I was like, what the fuck? And I got these for, what, I think I paid about $2 a piece, and they're all complete. I don't actually have a Genesis to test them, and I used to have all these games, but I was a fucking dumb kid and ended up selling all my shit because I talked to my sister the other day because I had Brave. She had bought me these games when they first came out. I had like Brave Fencer Musashi. I had both Parasite Eves. I had, it was another rare ass PlayStation game. But Parasite Eve isn't really that rare, but Brave Fencer Musashi is pretty expensive now. I haven't looked, but I know it's probably about $30 or $40, maybe. That's still a lot for a fucking PlayStation game. But I wish I still had those, but I don't really want those games anyway. But gonna start off with this shit I got. These are all the games I got. I got this at the place in town called Vintage Stock. I got all of these there. I got Dead or Alive 5 last round because they have the I hopped on the PlayStation 4 the other day and they have Dead or Alive 3 Fortune. They have a free to play version on the Japanese PlayStation store. So I downloaded it, played it. I was like, oh, this is all right. This is something I'll probably play, but you have to import it, and importing a copy of that shit is like $70. So I probably won't be doing that, but I played Dead or Alive 5 the other day and I was like, this game looks fucking amazing, dude. This is like one of the best looking fighting games. I watched a little bit of gameplay of Tekken 7, but this game looks fucking amazing. And with the free to play version on PlayStation, they only give you like 2 fighters. So I went ahead and bought this. It has all the fighters, but there's still 2 DLC ones that you can't play with. Like, it's like Mai and somebody else, but I got that. That game's fucking sick. They had this at Vintage Stock. Got this. I was just like, why not, dude? Because, I forgot that you could play Xbox games on your 360, so that's why I've really been passing up Xbox games, because I don't have an OG Xbox, but I'll keep a lookout for them now, since I could actually play them. I got this, Dead to Rights 2. Got this from the same place. It just doesn't come with the original case, but it's the actual game, so not a big deal. I got this, I think this is, yeah, I got this Tony Hawk's American Wasteland for $1. Can't beat that. I got this Sonic Adventure for the GameCube for what, a dollar? Can't really beat that. I ordered these off of eBay because I have these games, but I'm just going to say, if you own a PlayStation 2 and you know anything about it, I'm just going to say that I played all of my shit on ESR, and I'm not really into playing shit like that anymore. I want to actually have the physical copies because you don't have to worry about bugs and shit going wrong. But I got both of these. They were reasonably priced. I got this one off of Amazon. I think I bought this off of eBay. I thought this one came with the manual, but it actually didn't. But it really doesn't matter because this game sells for like 30. I got it for like 20. And I think I got this one for 22. But the case is kind of fucking beat up on this one. And it doesn't come in the, like, it's not, it doesn't have like the super original case because there's a little thing in here because this is a two-disc game. And like, there's like fucking like shit inside of the disc. Like, that happened in one of my games where I spilled something on and it like crept in there. But I tried both of them and they actually work. So I want to get the original Grandia, but I have it on the PlayStation Store and that shit really wasn't that fun to me. Like, I didn't really get into it until Grandia 2. And I've become a fucking strategy god whore because I went to, like, vintage stock is the shit because some of the places, some of the, they have like 7 locations in town. So I just go to every one if I'm by it. And they have these, like, they don't really give a shit about strategy guides. They sell pretty cheap. So some of them I get for 99 cents, some of them I get for $2. But I'm just like, it's better to have this strategy guide instead of pulling up the fucking video, the game facts on my fucking iPad and having to look at that shit and like fucking zoom in and out on text and shit. I'm probably gonna get this game. So I got this one. I got this because I was just thinking, like, maybe since the game costs so much, maybe this costs a lot. So I just got this, and maybe if I ever do play the game, I'll have it. So I got the Resident Evil Outbreak. I got the Dot Hack. I got this because I actually try to get strategy guides of games that I actually have or I'm going to get. So I got this. Pretty cool. I cannot believe I fucking found this, dude. They had this there. I already know Grandia 2 like the back of my fucking hand, but still sick having something like this. And I was pissed because they had a Tales of Symphonia art book there. I have never seen it before. They only wanted $2 for it. But when I picked up all of these, I was like, man, I'm not about to pay $2 for no fucking art book. Then when I went back the next day trying to buy it, somebody had already snatched it up. So I was like, fuck, I should have got it. So now whenever I see something like that, I'm going to just go ahead and grab it and quit being a little bitch. But I got the Grandia 2. I got the Clock Tower 3. I actually ordered this game because I got this strategy guide. So, I got that coming. I think I ordered this off of, I think I ordered the game, that the game off eBay too. I got it for like what? I think it was like 15, 16 bucks. So I got this strategy guide for a dollar though, bro. That shit's pretty cool. I got this because I actually have this game. So I was like, holy shit. I got this. I don't have this, but I was like, Zone of the Enders is fucking sick. And for a dollar, can't really beat it. I cannot believe I fucking found this there too, dude. Cause I fucking played the shit out of this game, but I've never beat it. So I could actually use this fucking strategy guide right now. And I was like, holy shit, bro. I was just like fucking amazed. Like, whoever had this collection, I'm pretty sure most of these came from the same person because they were just in there. Like, I was like, holy shit, bro. I've never fucking seen this. And I got this. Like I said, this is the only other game I'm really trying to fucking get because this game is fucking expensive as shit. And I looked on eBay and this strategy guide sells for like $30, but it was only like 2 on there, so you could pretty much pick your price. But I didn't even know they had a strategy guide for this, and this shit's super rare. So, well, the game is, at least. Never beat this game, so I'm playing through that. So I was like, shit, go ahead and grab that. That's a dollar. Cannot believe I got this either, because I'm playing through this game also, and I had my fact up on Game Facts, but now I could just use this fucking shit, so $4 couldn't really beat it. I'm playing through this game too, so fucking got that. And then Dead to Rights That was like a buck. Can't really lose on that one. And then I ordered these off of the GameStop. I ordered these from GameStop because I was trying to source a copy of Persona 2, and they sell for like $70-$80. It was somewhere, I think the cheapest one I seen was like $80, and it was the one that I was gonna buy that came with the case was close to the price of what I paid for the original Persona. So I start looking around, and GameStop actually had it, and they were only selling it for $50. But the thing is, you could probably get one that comes with the case, or you could probably get one that doesn't come with the case because you're ordering off the website. So I had a what I did, because I tried to sell my Last Guardian. I don't really sell my games, but I got two copies of the Last Guardian. So I tried to sell my shit on Craigslist, and this dude tried to trade me like some shit games, and I was just like, fuck it. Traded it into GameStop, put it down on this game, and then in the end, I think I only ended up paying like $38. And I was just hoping when it came, like, fuck, man, I hope it comes with the original case, but it didn't come with it. But I still paid like almost half the price of the game. But I don't know what I'm gonna do with the case. I'm probably just gonna get one of these PS2 cases that has the two slots in it and just put the two games in there and just try to find like a custom artwork that somebody has made and just print it out, because I got a shit ton of games that don't have a case. But I also ordered Persona 3 and 4, so I have those coming too. I ordered those off of Amazon, so I was just trying to get all the Persona games. And I talked to this dude today, because I was trying to, when I picked this up, I was in GameStop and I was opening it up, and he was like, hey man, you going, I see you buying the Persona games, like, which ones you got? And I was like, bro, this is the last one I need, like, I have all of them now, except Persona 5. He was like, you should start getting the Shin Megami Tensei. And I was like, man, I don't know. And honestly, I have every single one of the Shin Megami Tensei games that's on PSN. I've purchased all of them. So I already have them, and I'm not really that big a fan of SMT. I know Persona is an offspin of that, but I play SMT4, and that shit is just so fucking hard, dude. I'm dying in the first fucking dungeon, bro. Like, I'm like, all right, I ain't played this shit in 3 months. Hop on, first battle, my whole fucking party gets wiped out. I'm like, fuck you, man. That shit's so hard. And I thought Persona was fucking hard. That shit's tough. And I really like Nocturne, though. I played about 10 hours of that game, but I never finished it. And this is the only other thing that I got. The fucking Tales of Berseria Velvet Crow figure. And I didn't even know that they were releasing this. I just happened to hop on AmiAmi and look around, and I was able to grab this shit the day before they released it. And I was like, holy shit. But yeah, it's the fucking Tales of Berseria fucking Velvet Crow figure, which is pretty sick. I really like Tales of Berseria, so that's what really made me get this. And I'm pissed, bro, because they're releasing too many fucking Bushojos right now. Like, when I got on there and got this, there's like, they're releasing a Noir swimsuit Bushojo that comes out in like July, and I'm like, fuck, dude, y'all releasing too many fucking Bushojos. Like, this shit is expensive as fuck, y'all hurting me. But I think this one was what, I can't remember how much I paid for this. I think it was like 14,000 yen. Yeah, 14,000 yen sounds about right. So you can go from there with that. But yeah, that's, I think that's the last thing I got. Yep, so I was pretty hype on getting this because the character Velvet Crow is pretty fucking sick. So, but yeah, that's all the shit that I got, man. So we will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.